Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi has told us, إِذَا أَحَبَّ أَحَدُكُمْ أَنْ يُحَدِّثَ رَبَّهُ فَلْيَقْرَأَ الْقُرْآنَ. If one of you wants to converse with his Lord, then let him read the Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us words, special words by which to converse with him. In the same way that we pray every day, we should be reciting the Quran every day, because the two perfect one another. The prayer is that which is sent into the heavens, and the Quran is that which is descended into the hearts. And so these special words that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has designated for us to speak to Him with, they are His divine attributes concealed in human form, in human language. So one should realize the loftiness of these very special letters and words chosen that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed the Quran through. In the same way that we come to animals, to different birds, and the human syntax and eloquence is far too advanced for this bird to understand, and so we allow the bird to understand our commands or those things which we forbid through whistling or through a crack of a whip. Likewise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created words that conceal these divine attributes that could not be withstood by anything, not even by the divine throne. Had Moses not been strengthened by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he would not be able to withstand the language by which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke to him with. And so one should realize the loftiness of these words and realize that even though we cannot look directly at the sun, we can look at the sun ray that guides us to the sun. And this Quran is the sun ray that guides us to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the source. So Imam Khomeini, he describes it as the heart in the beginning when it's conversing with Allah, that it's like a child still. And so the tongue is that which recites, and the heart follows. And through sincere and determined and repetitive worship, slowly it is altered. The situation is altered and the tongue of the heart opens up. And the heart is that which begins to recite to Allah. And the tongue follows the heart. The situation before was that the tongue would recite and the heart would follow. Now the heart recites and the tongue follows the dhikr and remembrance of God in the heart. And that's why sometimes there are states the human being can reach that he would be asleep, but then he would be reciting Quran and dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because the heart is not restricted by sleep. It's not restricted by wakefulness. The heart is always in the remembrance of God, whilst the tongue follows the heart. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa alihi at-tayyibin at-tahirin.